टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट चैप्टर नंबर 4 मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. फर्स्ट इज व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय मेटल्स एंड व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय नॉन मेटल्स. वी विल स्टडी दीज टॉपिक एंड चैप्टर नंबर 4 क्लास 8 साइंस. यू आर फैमिलियर विद अ नंबर ऑफ मटेरियल्स लाइक आयरन, aluminium, copper, etc. Some materials have been given in the table 4.1. So as we know, the material iron we use in daily life, we use utensils of aluminium, and we use wires of copper. So we all use these materials in the daily life. And some materials are shown in the table 4.1. First is iron, and next is coal, and next is sulfur, and next is aluminium, and next is copper. You have to find which is shiny and which are dull. So iron is a shiny, so its appearance is shiny. Coal, it does not shine, it is dull, so coal is dull. And sulfur also appears dull, so its appearance is dull. And aluminium, and it also shines, and copper is also shine. So it also iron, aluminium, and copper are shining materials, and coal and sulfur are dull materials. And how can we distinguish on the basis of hardness? And iron, it is a hard material. Coal, it is not very hard material. And sulfur, it is also not very hard material. And aluminium, it is a hard material. And copper, it is a hard material. Can you name the materials which are metals? Can you find out of these 5 items which objects are metals? The rest of the material in the table 4.1 are non-metals. So in the 5 items, some objects are metals and some objects are non-metals. Metals can be distinguished from non-metals on the basis of their physical and chemical properties. So how can we distinguish which object is metal and which object is non-metal? So we can distinguish between metals and non-metals according to their physical properties or according to their chemical properties. So these are materials, iron, coal, and copper, these shine, but sulfur and aluminium does not shine. So this is the physical properties, and according to physical properties and chemical properties, we can distinguish between metals and metals. And recall, the lusters and hardness are physical properties. So you can find that lusters and hardness, these are physical properties. And what do you mean by lusters? Some object shines, which are called lustrous object, and which object does not shine are called non-lustrous objects. And what is the second property? Hardness. And so there are 2 properties. First is lusters and second is hardness. These are physical properties. First is hardness. Some objects are hard and some objects are soft. So first property is hardness and next is lusters, shineness. And these are physical properties. And we will study these properties of metal and non-metal in the next topic. So how can we distinguish between metals and non-metals? On the basis of their physical properties or on the basis of chemical properties. And what are the physical properties of metals and what are the chemical properties of metal? Which we'll study in the next topic. For next topic is physical properties of metals and non-metals. Have you ever seen a blacksmith beating an iron piece or an article made up of iron like a spade or shovel And X, do you find in the change in the shape article on these articles on beating? When we see that a blacksmith beats the iron piece and with the article made up of iron, suppose in the activity 4.1, the blacksmith is beating some pieces, some iron nail with the hammer. And this is beaten by the blacksmith, and this is an iron piece is beaten by the blacksmith. And if this article is made up of iron, like a spade and axe, so do you find in the change in the shape of this article when the blacksmith beats these iron nails? Is there any change in the shape of these iron nails? Would you expect a similar change if we try to beat a wood log? If we beat a wood log with the same instrument, is there any change in the shape? Let us find out. Then we will do activity 4.1. Take a small iron nail. Firstly, we will take small iron nail shown in the figure 4.1. And then we will take coal piece and a piece of, and then we will take a piece of aluminium wire. And then we will take piece of a pencil lead. So we will take four types of object. First is iron nail, and next is coal piece, and next is aluminium wire, and next is pencil lead. So we will take four types of material, and then we will beat the firstly iron nail with the hammer. As shown in the figure, we are beating an iron nail with the hammer. And then the first one preparation must be done. Doing these experiment, you take care you don't hurt yourself in this process. So try to hit hard also the aluminium wire. Then firstly we will hit iron nail, and then we will hit coal piece, and then we will hit aluminium wire, and then we will hit pencil lead. And what is the observation? Is there any change in the shape? Iron nail will change shape? Yes. Aluminium wire will change shape? Yes. Coal piece, it breaks. And pencil lead, it also breaks. So what is the observation? Two objects, just like iron nail and aluminium wire, its shape changes. And coal piece and pencil lead, it will break down. And you saw that the shape of iron nail and the aluminium wire changed on beating. When we beat iron nail and aluminium wire with the hammer, then what is the observation? They get changed on beating, and their shape is also changed. If they were beaten harder, this could be changed into the sheets. You might be familiar with silver foil used for decorating sweets. So when we use silver foil for decorating sweets, you must also be familiar with the aluminium foil used for wrapping food and the property of metals by which they can be beaten into thin sheets, and this is called malleability. So what do you mean by malleability? The property of metal by which they can be beaten into thin sheets, and this is called malleability. And this is the characteristics property of metal. So when we beat these type of metals with the hammer, then it changes into the thin sheets. And this is the property of metal. And what is this property? And this property is called malleability. When we beat iron nail and aluminium wire, its shape changes and it change into the sheets, and this property is called malleability. And what is the example of this in the daily life? We use aluminium foil, silver foil for decorating sweets and for packing our food. एंड दीज ऑल्सो मेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ बीटिंग द एल्यूमिनियम और सिल्वर वायर. सो दिस प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मेटल इज कॉल्ड मेलेबिलिटी एंड दिस इज अ प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मेटल. As you know, must have noticed, material like coal and pencil do not show this property. When we beat coal and pencil with hammer, then this other coal and pencil breaks down, and it will not change into the sheets. So these type of material does not show the property of malleability. So can we call these as metal? No. So what are metals? We show the property of malleability. Can you hold a hot metallic pan is without a plastic or wooden handle and not get hurt? When we take a hot metallic pan, which we used for making tea, and which is made without a plastic or a wooden handle and not get hurt, perhaps no. If we use a metallic pan without a plastic or wooden handle, and if we not get hurt, why we not get hurt? Try to list some experience in which a wooden or plastic handle protects you from being hurt while handling no things. On the basis of these experiences, what can you say about the conduction of heat by wood and plastic? When we touch the iron piece and iron rod, a warm iron rod, if one end is warm, then other end will also warm. And if we warm the wood and plastic, then one end of wood is warm, then other end will not warm. So wood and plastic will not conduct heat. So some materials will conduct heat and some materials will not conduct heat. And the materials which conduct heat are called metals. So you must have seen an electrician using this screwdriver, and what kind of handle does it have? Why? So again, I'm repeating these things. So there are two types of material. First is metal and next is non-metal. And what are metals? Metals can be classified according to their physical and chemical properties. So how can we distinguish between metals and non-metals? On the basis of their physical properties. And first is, what are their physical properties? First is lusters. So all metal shines, means the object which shines are called metals. And the objects which does not shine are called non-metals. And the material which are hard are called metals. And the material which are not hard are called non-metals. So which shows the property of lusters and hardness are called metals. So what are the properties of metal? First is lusters and second is hardness. First is lusters and second is hardness. So this is the property of metal. What do you mean by lusters? So means all metal shines. And next is hardness. All metals have hard surface. And next property is malleability. And what do you mean by malleability? When we beat materials with the hammer, then it changes its shape. So what do you mean by malleability? The property of material according to which it can be drawn into thin sheets. And this property is called malleability. When we beat these type of materials with hammer, then this convert into thin sheets, and this is called malleability. And this is called malleability. So iron nail, coal piece, aluminium wire, pencil lead, these are objects. एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड विच आर मेटल्स एंड विच आर नॉन मेटल्स. व्हेन वी बीट आयरन नेल विद हैमर देन इट्स चेंज इन टू शेप देन इट इज मेटल. When we beat coal piece, then it breaks down and it does not change its shape. Then it is not a metal. And when we beat aluminium wire, it also changes shape. Then it is a metal. And when we beat pencil lead with hammer, then it will not convert it into the sheets. It will break. And then it is not a metal. So iron and aluminium wire is a metal and others are non-metals. So what are the properties of metal? First is hardness and second is lusters and third is malleability. Next property is conduction of heat and electricity. Good conductor of heat and electricity, which we'll study in the activity 4.2. So firstly, we will make electric tester. How can we make electric tester? We used a bulb and wires and a cell. And when we connect these wires with the cell and we are checking some material for testing. Suppose we are checking for iron nail. If we connect iron nail with the cell or bulb, if the bulb glows, then it is a good conductor of electricity. And if bulb does not glow, then it is a bad conductor of electricity. So when we connect iron nail with the bulb, then bulb glows. Then it is a good conductor of electricity. So it is an electrical tester for testing whether an object is conductor or insulators. So we are repeating these experiments for the iron rod, sulfur, and for the coal piece, and also for the copper wire. What was the observation? When we connect iron rod with the cell, and when we connect sulfur with the cell, and when we connect coal piece with the cell, and when we connect copper wire with the cell, then what is the observation? In case of iron rod and copper wire, the bulb glows. But in the case of sulfur and coal, bulb does not glow. So iron rod and nail and the copper wire are good conductor, while sulfur piece and coal piece are poor conductors. So what do you find the use of aluminium and copper wire? Have you seen wires of coal? Definitely, as we use wires of aluminium and copper wires, we don't use wires of coal. So because iron and copper are good conductor of electricity, so these are metals. And what is the next property? Ductility. The property of metal by which it can be drawn into wires. When we take any metal, if it is converted into wires, then it is a metal. If it is not converted into wire, then it is non-metal. And this property is called ductility. And what do you mean by ductility? The property of metal by which it can be changed into wires. The property of metal by which it can be changed into wires are called ductility. So metal shows ductility property, but non-metal does not show ductility property. So what are the properties of metal? First is hardness, second is lusters, and third property is malleability. And next is good conductor of electricity and heat. And next is ductility. So these are properties of metal. First is hardness. Next is malleability and ductility. And next is good conductor of electricity and heat. These are all properties of metal. Have you ever noticed the difference in sound on dropping an iron sheet plate, a metal coin, or a piece of coal on the floor? If not, you can try it now. You can know you. Do you note any difference in the sound produced? Yes. If we drop an iron sheet or metal coin, a piece of coal on the floor, then there is a difference in the sound. Some materials will ring faster and some materials will not ring faster. Have you seen wooden bells in the temples? Yes, we have seen wooden bells in the temples. Can you give reason? The things made up of metals produce ringing sound when struck hard. Suppose you have two boxes similar in the appearance, one made up of wood and other of metal. Can you tell which box is made up of metal by striking both the boxes? Yes. Next property of the metal is sonorous. And what do you mean by sonorous? All the metals produce ringing sound, and this property is called sonorous. And the material and the metal show sonorous property. And what do you mean by sonorous property? Metal shows ringing sound. All metal shows ringing sound, and this property is called sonorous. And all metal shows this property. So these are physical property of metal. And when we compare wooden box and when we with the metal, and when we struck metal, and when we and also metal box, and when we struck with the wooden box, then the metal box produce ringing sound, but the wooden box does not produce the ringing sound. So because these are made up of metal, so these all metals produce ringing sound, and they are said to be sonorous. And all metal shows this property. So after doing so many activities, we find that all metals are hard, all metals are lustrous, all metals are ductile, and all metals are sonorous, and all metals are good conductor of heat, and all metals are good conductor of electricity. So if any material shows these property, are called metals. If all materials does not show these type of property, are called non-metals. So what do you mean by metal? Which are hard and lustrous and malleable and ductile and sonorous and good conductor of heat and electricity. So these are materials are called metals, and which do not follow these type of property. So these are called non-metals. So these are the physical properties of metal. So again, I'm repeating. So there are two types of material. First is metal and next is non-metal. So some objects are metal and some objects are non-metal. So how can we distinguish between metals and non-metals? Based on the physical and chemical properties, they can be distinguished. And what are the physical properties of metals? First is lustres. All metals shine. Just like iron, first activity is appearance and hardness of material. Because iron shines, coal does not shine, sulfur does not shine, aluminium shine, and copper shine. So iron and aluminium is metal, and coal, sulfur, and iron, aluminium, copper is metal, and coal and sulfur is non-metal. So iron shine, aluminium also shine, and copper also shine. So iron, aluminium, and copper are metals, and coal and sulfur is non-metal. So how can we distinguish metal and non-metal? First is on the base of lusters, the which shines are called metal, and which does not shine are called non-metal. And next is on the basis of hardness. When we check these five items, and iron is a hard, and aluminium is also hard, and copper is also hard, but coal and sulfur is not hard. So iron, aluminium, and copper is metal, and coal and sulfur is non-metal. So how can we distinguish between metals and non-metal? First is luster, and second is hardness. So our first activity for checking metal and non-metal according to the appearance and according to the hardness. So some objects which shine are called metals, and the some object which does not shine are called non-metals. And the object which are hard are called metals, and the object which are not hard are called non-metal. Next is when we beat some different objects with the hammer. This is activity 4.1. We are beating iron nail, and then we are beating coal piece, and then we are beating aluminium wire, and then we are beating pencil lead with the hammer. And iron, when we beat these type of materials with the hammer, then the iron nail will change its shape, and aluminium wire also changes to shape. But coal piece and pencil lead, it will break down. So the object which changes shape are called metals, and the object which does not change its shape on beating are called non-metals. And this property is called malleability. And what do we mean by malleability? This is a very important property of metal. The property of metal due to which it can change its shape when it is beaten by the hammer. The property of the material according to which they can be beaten into thin sheets are called malleability. And what do you mean by malleability? This is the property of metal according to which it can change its shape when it is hammered with the hammer. And this changes into shape, and the iron nail and aluminium wire change in shape, but coal piece and pencil lead, it will break down. So iron nail and aluminium wire is metal, but coal piece and pencil lead is non-metal. So first property of the metal is lusters, and second is hardness, and third is malleability. And what do you mean by malleability? It is a very important property of the metal according to which it can every metal can be changed into a change its shape when it is beaten by the hammer, and this property is called malleability. So which show the property of malleability are called metals, and which does not change the shape of shape, then it is called non-metal. And this is a very important property of metal. And what are the common daily life example of this property? We use silver foil for decorating fish and for packing our lunch. We use silver foil, and this is a sheet made by the when we beat aluminium metal, then these will convert it into the silver foil. And this property is called malleability. But the coal and pencils do not show this property, so these are non-metals. Next, first property is luster, second is hardness, and third is malleability. Next is good conductor of electricity and heat. When we use an electric fan, or hot metallic pan, if we have a metallic pan without plastic or wooden handle, then our hand will get hurt. And if there is a hot metallic pan, because metallic pan is made up of metal, and when we heat the hot metallic pan, when we heat the metallic pan, then the heat transferred from one end to the another end. Why it is transferred from one end to another end? Because all metals are good conductor of heat. And so the metals are good conductor of heat. So the material which are good conductor of heat are called metals, and the material which are not good conductor of heat are called non-metals. Next is how can we make electric tester? For the making of electric tester, we use bulb and we use a cell and wires. When we connect these cell with the wire and the bulb, and we check any material for testing. Suppose we are checking for the iron nail. If we connect iron nail, then the bulb glow. If the bulb glow, then the material is conductor. If the bulb does not glow, and this is insulator, means it is a bad conductor. You have studied this activity in the class 6 for checking good conductor or bad conductor. And this is the electrical tester. When we check these type of items, suppose iron rod, sulfur, coal piece, and copper wires. So iron rod, when we connect in this tester, then the bulb glows, then it is a good conductor. In the case of sulfur, bulb does not glow, then is a poor conductor. Coal piece, when we connect these coal piece, then this is a poor conductor. Then a bulb does not glow. And when we connect copper wire, then the bulb glows. Then this is a good conductor. So iron rod, nail, and copper wire are good conductor, but sulfur and coal piece are bad conductor. So these are the experiments for checking electrical conductivity of materials. So the material we show which are good conductors are called metals, and the which are poor conductor that are called non-metals. So these are called metals, and these are the properties of metal and non-metal. So what are the properties of metals? First is lusters, next is hardness, next is malleability, and next is good conductor of heat and electricity. Next is, what do you find the use of aluminium and copper wires? And next property is ductility. What do you mean by ductility? The property of metal by which it can be changed into the wires. The property of metal according to which it can be drawn into the wires are called ductility. And this is the property of metal. The material which can be converted into wires are called ductility, are called metal, and which does not show this property are called non-metal. So this is the property of metal. So what are the properties of metal? First is lusters, second is hardness, next is malleability, next is good conductor of heat and electricity, and next is ductility. Malleability and ductility is very important property of metals. Ductility and malleability is very important property of metal. And what do you mean by ductility? According to which it can be drawn into the wires. And next property of the metal is sonorous. When metal is struck by the any surface, then it produces ringing sound. When it is hammered by any material, then it produces ringing sound, and these type of objects are called metals. The object which shows the property of ringing sound means sonorous, then this is called metals. So what are the properties of metal? Hardness, lusters, malleability, ductility, and sonorous, and good conductor of heat and electricity. So the material which shows these type of properties are called metals and the material which does not show these type of properties are called non-metals. So in the next lecture, we will study about the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. In this class, we studied about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. And what are the physical properties? First is hardness. So all metals are hard. All metals are lustrous. All metals are malleable. All metals are ductile. And all metals are sonorous. And all metals are good conductor of heat and electricity. So these are property, physical properties of metals and hardness, luster, malleability, ductility, sonorous, and good conductor of heat and electricity. So these are called metals. And the object which do not show these type of properties are called non-metals. So any query regarding this topic? Students, any query regarding this topic? So you have to distinguish metals and non-metals on the basis of their physical properties. All metals are hard. All metals are lustrous, means all metals shines. All metals malleable, means it can be changed into thin sheets. And all metal can be changed into the wires, means all metals are ductile. And what do we mean by sonorous? All metals produce sounds, means all metals are sonorous. And all metals conduct heat, means it is a good conductor of heat. And all metals conduct electricity, means these are the properties of metals. And we can distinguish between metals and non-metals according to their physical properties. And malleability and ductility, it is a very important properties of metal. And what are their properties? What do you mean by malleability? And what do you mean by ductility? Well, according to malleability, according to this property, the every metal can be changed into thin sheets when it is hammered. And this is called malleability. And what do you mean by ductility? The property of material.